Some artists develop the language in continuity with the tradition. Others find their own way reacting against the tradition, saying a sonorous no to the music of the past. The French-American composer Edgar Varèse belongs with no doubt to the latter group. The Romanticism was permeated from a mystical attitude, and in Romantic music, every sound comes and takes its deep meaning from its connection to the silence. There is no opposition between artistic creation and nature, but rather a spiritual interaction between them. Listening, for instance, to Bruckner, Wagner, but even Webern, we can feel the sound live and feel how this living vibration is like a sacred manifestation of the cosmic beauty. But for Varèse, the nature which inspires us is not anymore a cosmic original dimension which embraces us all. Much more inspiring for Varèse is the environment we create to live in. So in modern times, the buildings, the streets, and the sounds of a metropolis are for Varèse the authentic nature which should inspire the structure and the contents of the arts. For Varèse, life is effort and progress, and art should be the mirror of this, thanks to a permanent technical innovation. Some composers of the second part of the 20th century tried to achieve this innovation by reforming the syntax of music. Varèse, in less intellectual way, doesn't try to find new musical grammars, but he innovates the vocabulary. That's why, for example, he will strongly increase the importance of percussion instruments, or why he will keep collaborating all his life long with scientists to create new instruments and new sounds, since he strongly believed that violins and pianos were old-fashioned and that they couldn't speak to modern people anymore. Varèse wasn't a futurist, but he does share, in my opinion, with Italian futuristi, a certain disgust for any academicism. And exactly like them, he claims the necessity of a new art, which is coherent and up-to-date with the spirit of the modern times. Art should sing the new values and new symbols of the modernity. So Varèse longs for a fast and telegraphic musical form, which might be a faithful mirror of the frenetic rhythm of our modern life, surpassing the verbose rhetoric of the previous century. Beyond the percussion instruments, into his music burst sound masses, beams of sound, reminding almost the shifting of planets and complex rhythmical structures, which are not the result of intellectual calculations, but are much more an instinctive and incisive representation of the sounds of the industrial civilization. So, not the composers of the past, but rather the objects, the natural phenomena, or even the urban landscapes seem to inspire Varèse. This blind faith in science and progress is today maybe one of the biggest menaces for the survival of our traditions and identity. But Varèse had, at his time, the genius to transfigure his somewhat naive and unsophisticated enthusiasm for our chaotic and frenetic world into a very personal, inventive, colorful, ironic, sparkling, and beautiful music.